So, you want to talk about speeding up a rebuild, eh? Take a look at where the Detroit Red Wings finished up in the past few seasons while Steve Yzerman has been back in town. It's not pretty if you take a look at their records and see just how many wins this team was racking up and just going by the year-by-year chart. So, let's go back to the last time the Red Wings actually made the playoffs and they lost, 2015-16. First round, Tampa Bay Lightning, 4-1. We all kind of remember this. Pavel Datsyuk was there. All the guys were still there. But it was a long 5 years of Red Wings hockey without making any playoff runs. In the 2016-17 season, they were 33-36-13, good enough for 7th in the Atlantic Division, which also was good enough to net them the third worst team position in the entire Eastern Conference, a big fall from grace for Detroit. If you're taking a look at this team and the amount of success that they had had recently, this was kind of the start of the downfall. Next up, 2017-2018, the Red Wings were just a tad better because in this season, hey, they were 5th in the Atlantic. 82 games played, 30 wins, 39 losses, and 13 overtime losses, so fewer points, but they had a higher standing in the division because other teams were worse than they were. Funny how that works. They were, instead of being 3rd last, now 4th last in the entire Eastern Conference. Go over to 2018-2019. 7th in the Atlantic again, 32-40-10, 40 regulation losses, man, not great. They're 3rd last in the entire NHL's Eastern Conference once more, and then you get to where things just kind of became sad. 2019-20, the Red Wings were last in the Atlantic, they were last in the league. 71 games played, 17 wins, 49 regulation losses, and 5 OT losses for 39 points on the year. Yzerman had taken over the year before, so you could see that this is sort of when things were at their lowest. Okay, the Red Wings suck, they're gonna get first overall, they're gonna get Lafreniere, nope, sorry, they can't even win the draft lottery. They slip all the way down to 4th overall and they take Lucas Raymond. So, it's about a year's past when Yzerman is actually at the helm when the 2019-20 season concludes. He came in towards the end of the 2018-19 season. 2020-2021, while it wasn't really a great year for anybody in Detroit, it was still a year where you saw this team. It was a young team going out there and doing their thing. 7th in the Central Division right now because they moved. It's no longer the Atlantic Division. It's the weird 4 divisions we had that year. 56 games played, 19-27-10. And they're still pretty down there in the standings. It's not really all too good of a season for the Red Wings when it comes to their record, but at the same time, it's like, okay, they're bad. Like, they were last in the league last year. You cannot expect this team to be all too good now, can't you? Take a look at the Central Division standings. They had a better record than only the Columbus Blue Jackets, and every other team here, Chicago, Dallas, Nashville, Tampa, Florida, and Carolina, bested out these Red Wings. And now you take a look at where things are today. The Detroit Red Wings in the 21-22 season have gone out there with a record of 26 games played, 13 wins, 10 losses, and 3 overtime losses for 29 total points out of a possible 52 points in 26 games. This team is all of a sudden above 500. And if you take a look at the Eastern Conference, sure, they're 7 points out of a top-tier playoff spot in the Atlantic Division, but they're right there in the wild card with Pittsburgh. The Columbus Blue Jackets are the closest team catching up to these Penguins and Red Wings, 3 points back with a few games in hand on the Red Wings and 1 game in hand on Pittsburgh, but the Red Wings are in a playoff spot. And we're only at the quarterway mark of the season. Now, I get it. This team is not supposed to make the playoffs, right? This team, coming into the year, nobody in Red Wings Nation was like, okay, we're going to make the playoffs, right? We're going to squeak in as a wild card team, and we're going to do some damage, you know, first time in the playoffs since Datsyuk and all them. Nobody thought that this was going to happen, right? Nobody thought the Red Wings would legitimately be a playoff contender. Not contender as in, like, Stanley Cup contender, but a playoff contender, you know? Contending for a playoff spot. The 5-game win streak really went out there and helped Detroit in this aspect, and sure, they lost the other night against Tampa. They're playing again later today, so we'll see if they can start up a new winning streak or whatever, but The Red Wings have been a lot better, just in totality, than people expected them to be. And it's to the point now where, I mean, the proof is in the pudding. They're in a playoff spot. Here's a tweet that I wanted to highlight to you from the perspective of the Red Wings and what exactly they have been doing so far. After last night's win, this was posted after the fifth win before they lost to Nashville the next day, the Red Wings are 13-9-3. The last time the Wings were four or more games above 500 was October 27th, 2016, when they started the 16-17 season 6-2-0. Now, I don't want to go into the mathematics behind Prashant's tweet over here. Four or more games above 500, you have to do the mathematics to multiply everything out by two and get the amount of achievable points. It's kind of all over the place. I don't care about that specifically, but what I do care about is just the notion that this Red Wings team has been at the best position statistically in terms of wins and losses today. Okay, no, maybe not today, maybe like before the Nashville loss, which is the best that they have been in five freaking years. 5 years ago was the 2016-17 season, the first year the Red Wings missed the playoffs after going on that absurdly long streak that shattered all the record books spanning back to the 90s. But the Red Wings now have turned things around in a hurry, and the Yzerman rebuild, I mean, look, Lucas Raymond and Moritz Seider coming onto this team and doing their thing, that helps. It very much does. I don't think this team would be anywhere near as successful if it weren't for those two guys. But how funny is it that everything sort of coagulates together in one season, which is this year, to create the picture-perfect, okay, now this team is starting to win scenario. Now this team is in the playoffs scenario. Not only do you have these two guys and Seider and Raymond who are doing their thing, but everybody else, hey, they're on top of their game too. Dylan Larkin is kind of bouncing back. Tyler Bertuzzi, even though he's missing the games in Canada, when he is in the lineup, he's doing pretty all right. Mark Stahl is honestly pulling his weight. The defensemen, sure, you could use a little bit of an upgrade over Danny DeKeyser, but you still have guys pulling their weight as well. You're doing all of this without Troy Stetcher too. The goaltending has been solid. I love Alex Nedeljkovic. Everybody in Detroit does as well. Thomas Greiss was a solid backup option last season, and guess what? He's still out there robbing games. This Red Wings team is all of a sudden a lot more fun to watch, and the entire thing that I said last season about, okay, small victories. Whatever it is that happens that is good, that's what the Red Wings fan base needs to focus on and cheer for, because there's not going to be all too many good things happening in the season. That philosophy is out the window. All of a sudden, we're a quarter of a way through the season, and the Red Wings have won 13 out of the 20-something games they have had. This is legitimately a playoff contender. Ah, my goodness, I can't believe I just said that. So, talk to me in the comments. Do you think the Red Wings are going to make the playoffs? I cannot believe I just made that quandary on this video over here, but that's something that I do think we have to start thinking about, because look, any team can go on a run, any team can start winning some games in a row, and any team can start losing games in a row too. All it takes is one losing skid to completely derail your playoff hopes. That's for sure the case with most NHL teams, but so far, the Red Wings haven't broken yet, and we're a quarter of the way through the year. Raymond, Seider, sure. The production has been a little spottier than we would have liked it to be compared to earlier on in the season. Raymond has stopped scoring. Trevor Zegras has caught up to him. Moritz Seider is getting overtime winners. It's all over the place in Detroit, but there are still other stories, other players, and other very fun things about this team, aside from the Raymonds and the Seiders doing their thing, because this team, this locker room, this body of players, it's just a really good group of guys, based off of everything that we have seen. You know, the leadership of Dylan Larkin, Mark Stahl over there too, heck, even Bobby Ryan when he was here. There are a lot of good names that you want to cheer for in that locker room, and you can see it. These guys want to cheer for each other too when they go out there and they score big goals, or when they go out there into overtimes. You can see the excitement on all of their faces. This is a young team. This is a bright team. This is a team that, honestly, in my opinion, like, I do think they are somewhat overachieving. But individually, for all the players involved, I'm like, yeah, okay, even though Raymond and Seider might be a lot better than we thought, like Larkin being as good as he is this year, that's not a surprise. Nedeljkovic being good, that's not a surprise. There are a lot of people on this team that are kind of just playing to the best of their abilities, and it's kind of funny how it's all coming together now, isn't it? So talk to me in the comments, what do you think about the Red Wings? Are they making the playoffs this year? That is a crazy question, especially to be asking this early into the rebuild, quote-unquote. But Steve Yzerman, man, the guy's done his job. Talk to me in the comments. What do you think? I hope you enjoyed. This was Josh Rolson, 99. and bye.